You really couldn't pay me to put this back on my face. I do not want to wear it for X, Y, and Z. Like, it's just not, it's not it, period. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? We're doing something a little special today. We are going to be ranking every skin tint, CC cream, BB cream, tinted moisturizer type of product that I've tried. And I know I actually usually grade all these products in their individual videos, and I'm gonna tell you guys, you should definitely reference those videos if you're interested in a certain product, because those are very thorough compared to what we're doing today. Today it's kind of like the battle of the skin tints. I'm actually inspired by another YouTuber. Her name is Jamie. Jamie Page's video actually came across my feed, and as you can see, she's doing all the tinted moisturizer she has, her holy grails, the things she said to avoid, just S, etc, etc. So I'm sure you've seen a similar graph to this where it's usually like S, A, B, C, etc, etc, but everyone's doing their own custom ranking for different things, whether it be Marvel movies, which the Marvel nerd in me totally appreciates, jelly bean flavors, chip flavors, to, you know, other things. People are ranking everything, and usually it's like S for like supreme, superb, A through whatever. So today we're gonna do a little custom situation where we're gonna do a tier like that, but we're gonna have A, squad, varsity. We have better than the rest for B, because they are, like, they're not better than A, but they're pretty substantial on their own. Then we have C for cop a sample, which is, you know, it's worth a try. It might not be really, you know, worth it, but if you're just bored and you want to try something, you know, cop a sample, give it a go. And then next we go into N and Y. Yeah, I know we're not following letters, but give me a break. N's gonna be not really for me, respectfully, but all this is meant respectfully. This is just my experience and my opinion. Everyone's is different. I recently saw on TikTok someone say their favorite, like, holy grail foundation was literally my least favorite foundation, but she has dry skin while I have, like, oily combo textured skin and acne prone, so it's a totally different world. And that really proved it to me, which was, it was crazy. Like, when she turned the foundation around, I was like, oh, like, I would have nightmares. Not literally, but, like, that was my least favorite formulation I've ever tried in over a decade. And it's, like, her holy grail. So that's just, you know, respectfully. And then last tier would be, you couldn't pay me. You really couldn't pay me to put this back on my face. I do not want to wear it for X, Y, and Z. Like, it's just not, it's not it. It's not it. And you will not get it back near me, even with a 10-foot stick, like, period. So those are going to be our tiers. Kind of exciting. I'm doing 25 different skin tints right now, so all these are still available on the market. I wanted to focus on the ones I've reviewed that aren't discontinued. Obviously, that helps nobody. So 25. I can't give you guys a minute each on each product, but I'm gonna go by tiers and explain why. And they're in order on their tiers as well, so that's a whole different thing. They're going against each other. I know I've graded them, but this should be more insightful in a way, because basically you get to see them go head to head and which one I think is better, even if they're all A's or all B's or all C's, etc. But before we get into ranking, I want to introduce you guys our sponsor of the day, which I'm sure you've heard of. They're very, very popular in the online therapy community. I was actually very, very excited to be working with them today. I was quite honored, to be honest, because I've been curious. I've mentioned to you guys recently that at 29, I really have a regret that I didn't start therapy sooner, but honestly, it wasn't in the financial cards, and I think that's how a lot of people feel about therapy. And with the recent years, a lot of virtual options became more realistic options for people, and BetterHelp, like me and BetterHelp, we're having a thing right now. So I actually started therapy 2 weeks ago, and I'm doing a week to week, like one appointment every Wednesday. You girls working on herself for herself, you know, of course everyone around me as well, but like it's time. And I've been really interested in therapy. I think everyone needs therapy for good or for bad. Like, it's helpful to everybody, no matter what you have going on. For me personally, what's interfering with my life is, of course, my anxiety and my depression. I've mentioned this. I don't dive too deep into it, but I think a lot of people who do this job, social media wise, have a lot of challenges that we face that people sometimes invalidate. I've done this my entire life since 16, so a lot of things have come with that. But aside from that, I also have abandonment issues. I have attachment issues. I have panic attacks, and I'm super triggered by change. And these things are really kind of interfering with the happiness in me, like achieving my goals. Some days I'm just not moving at all, and some days I'm just too hard on myself. I am my worst enemy, and sometimes it's nice to have someone who is not in your direct life help you through this. Someone who's a trained, licensed professional. Every therapist is experienced, they're accredited, they have a minimum of 3 years experience and 1,000 hours on hand experience. And you have the option, depending on who you are matched with, of course, you can do a phone appointment, you can do a like text message, you know, through their portal appointment. appointment, their dashboard, their website, their app. They have an app. Or you can do a video chat, which is what I'm doing because I'm more of that like face-to-face. I like to make a connection. Hello, I have attachment issues. And I have super bad social anxiety. So that actually really helps me because though I'm very comfortable talking, I'm probably not comfortable internally. Like I'm so used to, because of my career, just speaking, but I'm also speaking in a room by myself, that this kind of helps bridge that gap and makes the first step to bettering myself and helping myself a little easier. And I really appreciate that BetterHelp has all of these options. And it is quite affordable compared to a lot of traditional online therapy. So it's actually $60 to $90 a week, depending on like which subscription plan you decide to go with, depending on if you're paying for the entire year. It's all on a sliding scale. So generally it's billed every 4 weeks. So you pay monthly $60 to $90 a week. You do the math times four, there you go. So let's assume it's at 60, that's 240. And honestly, that's really great because locally I've spoken to a few people and the average for online or in person, like with the same therapist, is about $175 per appointment. So I'm not going through insurance. BetterHelp is like pretty much 60 to 90 per week, billed every 4 weeks. It's really nice and easily formatted. There's no guessing in it. And compared to like 240 a month and only getting two appointments, I get more appointments. And even if it was $90 a week, honestly, I still get more appointments. I get more bang for my buck. That's amazing. And I like that they match you with a therapist that works with your needs and works, you know, with what you are presenting to the table mentally. And you can also change your therapist for free. Like they'll rematch you. You can easily fill out what you would like differently. And even when you're signing up, you can fill out your preferences, whether it's age or gender or just viewpoint, like what you feel comfortable with. So the options there are amazing. If you are interested in trying BetterHelp for yourself, I absolutely encourage you to take that extra step because I really regret not doing it sooner. So if you want to check out BetterHelp, feel free to use my link, which is betterhelp.com/samich. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/samich, my screen name. And you can get 10% off your first month using my link. Give it a go. BetterHelp works worldwide and you can log into your account at any time, schedule appointments, message your therapist at any time. You even get a private journal where you can type out your feelings where no one, including your therapist, has to see it. If you have social anxiety like me, you won't have to deal with the like awkward waiting rooms, and it's timely. The responses are all thoughtful and I've been able to reach my therapist even between our appointments, which is amazing. So thank you again to BetterHelp for sponsoring us and helping us, not just mentally, but also keeping the lights on today. I can't wait to update you guys with my progress throughout the next few weeks and months. So without further ado, let's get into ranking. All right, should we start from the top? Make it drop? What do we want to do? Want to start from the bottom? I'm talking like you guys can actually give me some feedback right now. I feel like we should start from the top. So we'll go from the best to the worst. Again, subjective, respectfully. All right, babes. My favorite skin tint, tinted moisturizer, BB cream, all of the above, is actually by L'Oreal. So I don't have every product in person, so you guys will just have to see sometimes a picture. Some things have expired, some things were returned, some things were thrown away, some things were donated, etc., etc. Here we are. So I have a couple. I have quite a few, possibly around almost half, but half of them I don't. So number one in the A squad, L'Oreal True Match. Love her. Also keeping her company is Fenty Easy Blur, also a newer product. Both of these came out this year. And then our last A tier would be by e.l.f., another affordable option. This is the Camo CC Cream. This did not come out this year, but it's been killing the game since its release. It is still kind of a recent product within the last few years, but it's amazing. These are my three top tier products. The only tier that I have all three products in, that's saying a lot already. They're the Varsity Squad. Between the three, I think L'Oreal, to me, the consistency is what I need. It's so good. It's long wearing, like chef's kiss. The easy drop, you have to go check out the review because we had a little bit of a roller coaster there, but all in all, an amazing texture. And then also the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream is just like foolproof. I have a lot of videos on them. Check them out. Honestly, these are probably more of the higher coverages for skin tints. Between the three, Fenty being probably the most sheer. But as far as skin tint goes, these still have the like best buildable coverage. But also, I'm big on comfort. So these are giving me flawless, but also natural, but also comfortable. Go check out their reviews. Absolutely, the A squad, claps for them. I wish I could snap. I can't, that's my nail, but snaps for them. Next up, the B B-tier. So B-tier, better than a lot, speaks for itself, right? We got a few members. So I have a few here. Let's start with them. Top of the B-tier is NARS Pure Radiant Tinted Moisturizer. I literally put the best question mark in its title. And honestly, aside from its transfer issues, it's actually really great. So if we ever go to a massless society again, which who knows if that will ever happen, we'll see. This could be an A-tier product. It's very close. That's why it's the top of the B-tier. Absolutely love her. Next up, we have Glowish, a newer release from Huda Beauty. This is the more natural side of Huda Beauty's products. I really like the Multi-Dew Skin Tint. It is interesting shade-wise. I highly recommend the review just for shade references there. Next up, I do not have, but it's the IT Cosmetics CC Matte in the Teal Tube. She is actually really good. She expired on me though. I would say better than the original. The original is not in this tier, so that's saying a lot. For my skin type, I've tested both, and this is also a similar coverage to the A Squad with a few other little minor concerns, which I did touch base in its own video. I honestly think it's the best product IT Cosmetics has for an oily skin gal or even combo skin gal. I really like the CC cream they have that's in a compact, but she's not in this video because like she's kind of inconsistent as far as like amount of product, price, and availability. So she's not in this video, but CC Matte, absolutely B tier, amazing. Next up, the Maybelline Fit Me. She's new. She threw me into a whole ride. Like, thumbnail itself says, do not make this mistake, because I realized you have to work so fast with this product. So keep that in mind. But if you prime and you use this product correctly, it's amazing for the price. And another thing on the B tier, last but not least, very affordable, NYX Bear With Me. So I haven't worn this in a bit, but this is their tinted skin veil that has only a few shades, but it will do. It's not a bad range. It has a few shades. This is beige camel. I haven't worn it in a while, and I remember loving it so much when I reviewed it. Like, it was on my face on and off camera for a while, and it's quite affordable as well. These are available. These are decent ranges. These are decent price points, and overall better than a lot. So if I was going somewhere that I didn't want to break out the A Squad, and you know, maybe I'm running low and I want something affordable, the B Squad will do it. So we started with the high end B Squad, which honestly, it's in order. So NARS, Glowish, IT, Maybelline, NYX. Moving on. I feel like I'm talking fast, but I'm also talking about 25 products, so okay. Now we're getting into a little bit of a steamy area. We're in tier C. Tier C, starting off with something I don't have, the IT Cosmetics Original CC, which is in the silver tube. She's great, but the matte is better for my skin type, and it also has better shades. It actually came out with more shades originally than the original. Interesting enough, I think the CC Original would be great for those who are a little bit more normal to dry. I like it a lot too with powder, but at the same time, the finish of the matte without the powder way better. So she's gonna start off tier C for us. Next up would be the Beauty Blender. Recent release. It's the Bounce Skin Tint. I like within 3 videos ago reviewed it. Check it out. She's not a bad thing. She's definitely better than the original Bounce to me. She's worth a sample, thus being in this tier. She almost made it to be close enough, but I did have a few concerns that you'll see in my video. The next product would be Charlotte Tilbury's Hollywood Flawless Filter. So C tier, this is like a very, very popular product throughout the entire beauty community. I have this in a highlight shade, which is in 3 light medium, because that's kind of what I would prefer it for, like selective application compared to all over the face. Though I do love a good like natural skin like finish. I'm not a matte girl, honestly. My skin doesn't need super, super matte. I can't do super, super dewy, unfortunately. It's just not how my pores are built. So this is better selective for me. A lot of people love it. I think it's a little pricey, but some people, you know, live, breathe, and die by this. But for me, I think it's worth a shot. It has a doe foot, so you could easily swatch this in store. Obviously, don't put it on your face, but swatch it in store and give it a go. Charlotte Tilbury is not the most affordable, so it has to really knock it out of the park to make it into a higher tier for me. Next up is a product from Hailey Beauty. This is not what it looks like anymore. This is the old packaging. They recently changed all their packaging to white, I believe. This is their previously known as, I don't know if they renamed it, but the Reinvent. Ironic. And it's like a BB drop. Really nice. It has marula oil in it. It's a really dewy finish, but a really lightweight product because it's mainly an oil base compared to a cream or a liquid. It's great, but sometimes it's inconsistent about what I can use with it. So if I stick to the same like products that I know work with it, it'll be good. But this is like a little scary sometimes because it's so lightweight. Sometimes other products will wipe it away depending on what bronzer or cheek or even sometimes powder I want to use. I have to be a little bit more careful because the consistency is so thin. But overall, it's good. I think it could use a few more shades. Price price isn't bad. So cop a sample if you can. Literally, I don't think you can cop a sample for everything, but that's just what the tier is called, and that's just how I feel about it. Like, we're not fully committed yet, if you know what I mean. I really like the consistency though, if I was just wearing it by itself, but if I wanted to add a lot more, then it goes some places. But that is my equivalent for the Glossier Skin Tint. Like, this gives me just the right amount of coverage for a kiss of color and a really, really lightweight, like watery consistency. It's really nice. Last two were actually reviewed back to back. So this is the Wet n Wild Tinted Hydrator. I like it. It was decently long wear, but it also has like the worst shade range, to be honest. And it had a few other little issues. It was better than the next product, that's why she's ahead. But she's very affordable. I actually got this at Five Below because I couldn't find it in my other stores. And that's one thing about Wet n Wild, you can definitely find it there. It's an interesting review, so I would highly recommend giving it a go. You can't really sample this one as well, but for the price, that's where I'm at. You could go grab it, but don't get too invested. Don't spend your last $5, $6, $7, $8 on this product. The product that was viewed right before it was the Urban Decay Hydrator. So she's actually last on this tier. Love the packaging, love the concept. Actually wasn't that hydrating for me, but it had moments, kind of. Again, a very interesting video. I actually said in the Wet n Wild review what it was better than the Urban Decay in certain qualities. So a lot of comparisons there. That closes off our C tier. Next tier, second to last, are N, not really for me, respectfully, Kosas. Kosas is starting us off. Very, very infamous product. I see it everywhere. It is a watery consistency. It's very similar to the next product on the tier list right after it, which is the Glossier Skin Tint. She equally is watery, very, very thin. We're not going for coverage here, we're going for kiss. And I have too many acne scars for this to work out for me, but also it's not that long wear on me. And I get it. The thinner the consistency, the less likely it's staying on your face. I think this stays on my face a lot better. That's why she made it into a different tier. So I'm saying. But if you're gonna be on my face, make it worthwhile. Not coverage wise, but like, give me something. Give me like pretty finish. Give me not transferring all the time, every second. Like, don't be sticky. Be comfortable. You know, give me something to work with. And unfortunately, I don't feel like these are for me. The Kosas was okay in certain aspects. They're very quick and they're very great for those who like to apply it with their hands, which is also not me. So moving on to the next, which would be not this product, but a very similar packaging. It's the Bare Minerals Complexion Rescue. So a lot of people swear by this daily. This is actually the primer to go with it. I don't have it anymore. I reviewed it years ago and it's okay. I can't see myself using that as my go-to daily, like tinted moisturizer, sunscreen situation. It didn't knock me out the park, thus ending her here. The next product, it's Laura Mercier's Tinted Moisturizer. Very, very popular and you see it all around. Like, you know this packaging, I'm sure. I had a really hard time applying this for some reason. I was actually shocked how hard of a time it gave me in my review. The shades are also a little confusing. It took me like 3 different purchases to find something that worked for me. So that was interesting because I can wear their foundations no problem, but the tinted moisturizer was just not matching. Weird. Next on the tier is ColourPop's Pretty Fresh Skin Tint, which is like loved in the beauty community. Love. Everyone adores this except for me, unfortunately. Thus ending it up here. I think it's absolutely worth a shot. It's so affordable. Its consistency, the coverage reminds me a lot of the L'Oreal that's in the A tier, but my skin one can't handle it. I literally titled the video an emotional roller coaster because my skin actually broke out on camera from it. There's a lot of coconut water, I believe. I don't know if it's coconut water or coconut oil. It might be both, but I think it's coconut water. And my face did not like that at all. Like, it got itchy, it got irritated, and I can't take it. But a lot of people who are also acne prone wear it. So it could just be a me thing. But because of that, one, I can't wear it really. But I also had a few other issues towards the end of my review. So go ahead, check that one out. This one may check it out. I know, I'm so sorry. But this is just like a sum up. I warned you. Last but not least in our not really for me tier would be Milani's Glow Skin Tint. I recently reviewed it this last month. It's quite shiny and I like a good dew. Like, dew me up, girl. Like, give me fresh sprinkler. You know, give me reflective sun. I'm cool with that. That was too much. It was over glow. It was overdone and it couldn't be for my skin type, at least on this face specifically. So she's gonna end our end here. And then we're gonna move on to the last and final. You could not pay me to wear this tier. And they were pretty close already, those last two products, from jumping to this tier. So we have 5 products. L'Oreal. She started the video. She's starting this tier too. The Skin Paradise. It's like 70-something% water. Also something within like the last like 6 to 8 months that I reviewed. I know because I was already living in this house. She was, the range is just bad. Let me just say, the skin tone's not good. It's a little orangey, it's bad. And I'm pretty sure I'm a light or a fair shade in that line. It's not it. It's not it at all. I have nothing good to say, unfortunately. Yeah, that was a disaster. So if you feel like watching kind of like trash TV, you could totally watch that review. But respectfully, I'm always trying to be respectful while being honest. Next up, Morphe Glow Setter. Recent review. I thought it was gonna give me more, like the line, the range, the skin tones available was actually pretty impressive. I didn't like it. Like, there was nothing special about it, and I really would never want to put it on again. It felt like a waste of time. It's one of those products I couldn't wait till the review was over, oddly enough. Next up, Lancome. Skin feels good. I have no clue why I still have this. I think part of me hopes that it will jump up a tier in my life and just perform differently because so many people look so good in this. Unfortunately, I've had this for about a year now. I believe I got it last November or even last November. Do I need to throw you away? I don't know. I just know it was around Black Friday and it might not have been in this house. So I think I need to throw her away anyway, but it's a pump. It has, you know, a heftier price tag because it is Lancome. This has such good advertisement and this looks so good on so many people, but it does not stay on my face. It comes off so easily even before I'm done with my makeup. It's so frustrating to use. I can't get it to look good at all. So it's a no. It's an absolute no. I think she's gonna have to go in the trash after her final debut here. This actually hurts my heart because I love the brand. I'm wearing their blush right now. This is M Cosmetics Daydream Cushion. I was gonna say Daybreak. Daydream. So packaging, amazing. It's a pillow cushion with a teardrop. Really well thought out. The formula just does not go with me. I think the shade range is so-so, but it is a SPF 50 product. I love a good cushion. Like, K-Beauty cushions, amazing. But it kind of broke my heart in its review. I would not wear it again, and I even have extra refills for it. And I just wish it could work for me. It just really doesn't sit well with my texture and doesn't feel comfortable throughout the day, unfortunately. It sounds so good though. Its stats are amazing. And last but not least, my least favorite tinted whatever. This is actually very interesting that it's last. It's the one thing that kind of rides the line of, does this really count as one of these applicable products? Because we're not doing any of the foundations. We're doing CC cream, BB creams, tinted moisturizers, and skin tints. And though this is called a foundation from its recent review, this LA Girl tinted foundation ain't a foundation. This is a skin tint. They should have called it a skin tint. So I'm gonna call an audible. It's the last product and literally the last on the last tier. This is not good to me. Like, respectfully, not respectfully, like low-key, high-key type of thing. It's supposed to be hydrating. It's supposed to be lightweight. It's supposed to be sheer. It's very sheer. The packaging's pretty good. The range is really good. The price is really good. The formula is not. It's not good. It's one of those I wish I didn't review it. It kind of wasted my day. I could have reviewed something else type of product. And a lot of people wanted to say on that review, I think, that like, oh, like I wish people understood what skin tints are. And I get it. Like, that rides the line of this product. Like, I like a thin formulation. So, special guest, I forgot to include her, but she's the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Hydrating Tint. She's also very sheer. She doesn't have the greatest shade range, but I like this. This is actually more of a cream consistency than the really, really liquidy ones, but it blends out very, very sheer. I could ride with her. She could go into a COPPA sample, really, but the other ones are sheer to the point that I just don't know why I bothered. You know, like sheer, like you're sheer and then you come off really easily within an hour. Why did I bother type of feeling? So I got a lot of texture. I got a lot of redness. If you can't even help just a little bit in these situations and you're not pulling your weight on this team project and, you know, we gotta part ways. So that's how I feel about that. And whew, I didn't think I could do this, but we did it. Like, we got through this many products, guys. Thank you. You made it to this point. Snaps for you. Snaps that can't snap. Amazing. If you've made it to this point, give me this. Give me this emoji. Yeah, give me this down below. Thank you so much for joining me on this wild ride. Don't forget to check out my links down below. There's gonna be a lot of links today, holy moly. And I also have my blog where I link off all my shade comparisons if you're interested in any of these things. If you wanna see any of its reviews, just type my screen name and type whatever brand or product and it should come up in the search box pretty easily. Thank you guys so much for joining me. Thank you again to BetterHelp for partnering with us and sponsoring us today. Make sure you guys check them out. If you've been curious, give it a go. Give yourself a little window of time. I gave myself to the end of the year, like, to really get an opinion, and I'm doing weekly appointments, so I'm gonna get at least 15 appointments in, and I can't wait to update you guys. Like I said earlier, if you guys want to check out my recent uploads, I'll put them on the screen right now. I hope no one got too offended. Feel free to ride and die for your products, but I mean, I'm coming just as an opinion thing. This is not cemented in stone, just my opinion. My subscribe button will be right here if you have not hit that yet and you would like to join for more beauty lifestyle content, a little bit more of this face and this big old rambling mouth. I appreciate you guys so much for stopping by. Thank you for spending some of your day with me. I will see you guys in a later video.